Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Glitter's World, and this is Chunky. So today's video is a bit different. So today's video I'm gonna show you how you can carry your chumpy hair, that is previously night you might have done a hair oil and morning you have to move out of some emergency and commitment. So you can have a basic makeup on and you can go out. So today I'm gonna oil my hair in front of you guys, and then I will be doing a basic makeup, and then obviously I will be changing the dress and I will be heading out. Actually thought of why not sharing the tip, because I have been doing this along and I was been always appreciated by my colleague or my friends. They always used to surprise like how you can carry so much oil in your head and still you look pretty. So I'm not appreciating myself, but you can do this. Just understanding your hair, kind of makeup you can apply and kind of dress you can carry. So yeah, if you're interested then keep on watching. So yeah, in this hair oiling I'll be using two oils. So you might have seen this. First thing, I'll be using this Vatika Dabur Enrist with olive hair oil, where you have almond oil, aloe vera gel, everything is good things are here. And this is for extra hair fall control, still bouncy and silky. And I wanted to finish this. This is Amla oil from Patanjali. So I guess it costed me 40 rupees and it costed me 110 rupees. So I'm gonna mix this to oil and I'll be applying on my head. So you might have used some oil and all. So this is just a general oiling I'll be doing, and after that I'll be doing my makeup. So yeah, I'm back, and this is the oil. It's very difficult to show. So I will be using this oil for my hair. So already my hairs are a bit greasy because I had a heavy oiling and I didn't shampoo it so much. So combed it. And I will be doing a fast forwarding for this massage routine, because otherwise the video will be too long and I don't want this video to be so long. But if you guys want me to do a massage tutorial in a thorough process, then you let me know. I'll be doing it in a separate video, but this will be a quick massage. So in this I've already combed my hair and doing the general oiling. So I'm using my hands, I'm just trying to do it quickly. So it's just a light massage I'm doing to my scalp and trying to spread the oil to my ends also and giving a slight massage. I was really feeling relaxed while doing this. Obviously it would be better if somebody else does your massage, but yeah, I have to film it, so obviously I have to do. Now it's really advised to flip your hair down and do back massage also, because it gives a proper blood circulation to your head. So whenever I do massage, I make sure that I do at least for 3 to 4 minutes, keeping your hair down and doing the massage, so that your blood flows from down to up. So it helps a better hair growth for your head. So yeah, I did oiling and just put a hairband so that my hairs are back, and I have changed my dress now. Start with the base makeup. First thing, I'm gonna prime my face with this L'Oreal Majeed, just a little bit. I have already moisturized my face. This is a very smooth one. I'm gonna put on eye also, so it acts as like eye primer. And I'm gonna take this foundation, Maybelline, just a one pump set. I'm gonna dot it all over my face. Always include your neck. And now it's a basic. I am taking my Maybelline foundation and blending it with the beauty blender Beauty Blender helps your foundation to blend it really smoothly. So I'm doing this. Next is I'm taking the Maybelline concealer and trying to highlight and conceal my under eyes. Although I don't have much of dark circles, but still I wanted a brightening effect to my eyes. I'm using the concealer and just gonna blend with the same Beauty Blender. Just slightly, you know, pat the blender in your skin. Don't rub it, just pat it down. So once it is set, I'm gonna set with this Nivea loose powder. Just to set your concealer, wherever I have used the concealer, I'm just gonna set with a loose powder. Just trying to give a, you know, baking effect in my eyes. Although I won't be using heavy eyeshadow, but still I baked because that time I was not sure with what look I'll be doing. So just for an advance, I did a little bit of baking under my eyes. And leftover, I'm just running with my neck. Then I'm taking my L'Oreal Compact and again, I'm just using for whole of my face using the brush. All these brushes are, you know, very affordable, available in Amazon. You can check every time and, you know, buy it for your convenience. All the products, whatever I'm using, will be mentioned in description box. So do check that description box for your reference. Now I'm taking a Lakme Absolute, you know, range, the Sunkissed Bronzer. I'm just gonna do a slightly bronzing, because after foundation, or your face looks so flat, so I don't like that. So just a little bit of bronzer, not too harsh, just a little bit of contouring so that the face look a bit of sculpted. And I'm using the same brush to blend it, and I'm gonna dust it off the powder. I'm doing the same in my nose also and my forehead also, just to look the foundation very natural. And now just taking the brush and just spreading wherever I have powderiness, I'm just removing that. I'm taking the L'Oreal eyebrow kit and I'm just gonna shape my eyebrow. So wherever I have gaps, first taking the dark shade and just lining it. Sorry guys, I'm just going a bit out of frame because I was trying to look into the mirror and I think I went off camera. So please adjust this time. Next time I'll be, you know, I'll make sure that I don't go out of frame. So yeah, done with the first eyebrow. You can see the difference. And now I'll be doing the other, another eyebrow. Just filling the gaps now. This L'Oreal eyebrow kit is really nice. It gives a very natural effect to your eyebrows. And with the same spoolie, I'm just brushing it off so that there should be no harsh lines. So yeah, almost done. You can see my eyebrows look so natural and so look so good, like so much in shape. Now I'm using the Maybelline Quad and I'm using the lighter shade just to highlight my brow bone using the same sponge which comes with that palette. Just trying to highlight by the shimmery shade. I'm taking the golden kind of shade and using all over my lid. I just wanted to give a definition to my eyes, so I'm just using my hand because these are more of glittery and it is best to use your hand because the pigments exactly stick to your eyes better than brush. Now next I'm taking L'Oreal Sapphire Blue Eyeliner and I'm gonna draw a thick wing liner here. So it is in blue color. Thought of taking a, you know, different, instead of doing black, I thought of doing a Jessup in liner, so I'm using a blue liner. I don't know, I mean, I have all the shades of L'Oreal liners, but I don't know, with this blue, the pigments doesn't come so smoothly compared to brown and black. Just in one stroke, it gives me so much pigmentation, so smooth. I think I might have received a defective one because I ordered from Amazon itself. I don't know, something is there with this blue one, the pigments are not really good and I have to swipe a few times to get the pigmentation or to get the opaque, you know, color in my eyes. So yeah, I started with a, you know, small strokes until I'm satisfied. I'm just, you know, thickening the line and just extending the line to get a perfect wing liner. So yeah, I'm just filling it up. Now again I'm using the same palette and taking the lighter shade to highlight my inner corner of my eyes. I'm gonna take the darkest shade from the same palette. I'm gonna use in my lower lash line, so that gives an illusion of, you know better lashes in your lower bottom lash line too. So I always prefer to use brown. I don't want to use any kajal or no white pencils, so I use brown, kind of mix of colors, so it gives a better illusion of your lash lines. So now I'm gonna curl, and after that I will be using Maybelline Magnum mascara, and it gives really very long lashes kind of effect. You can see the difference because one, I am using this mascara, it's the same in bottom. It's a bit difficult to use in bottom, but still I'm trying to manage. So yeah, it really makes your lashes bigger than what they have, what they are. So I'm done with both the eyes. Now after that I thought of, why not doing a glittery eyeliner. So last moment I decided to put this Revlon Eye Studio Eye Art just from half, not exactly covering whole liner, but from the middle I'm just doing this, so it gives a glittery kind of effect. It's totally optional, so I wanted to add a bit of drama, so thought of adding this. And it looks really nice. Now I'm using the same golden and thought of adding in my crease also, kind of just blending it. It's a bit golden, so I thought of, I'm wearing an orangish jumpsuit with a lot of colors, so thought of adding golden will look nice. And doing the same in the inner corner also. Sorry guys, I'm just going a bit of out of frame. So yeah, you can see now. Now I'm gonna use a Maybelline Cheeky Glow blush, which is in coral color, and it really gives a nice color to your cheeks and very natural. So really I have all the shades of Maybelline blushes. Now I'm using the Sivana highlighters and I'm just rolling all over and just using on my high points, nose and cupids, and again the cheekbone and temples of my head. That's all. It is not catching in camera, but on off camera it is really, you know, highlighting your face. So I was trying to show on camera, so I was trying to put more. Then last step is lipstick. This is currently, I'm loving this. This is Faces Midnight Rose, and it is so gorgeous color. It's not red, it's not maroon, it is in between. I just love this shade, and again I'm out of frame, but I'll be, yes, this is the color. This is so nice color. I wanted to use a bow. Face look I wanted to show you guys. Now for hairs I have two options, so whether if you carry a hairband or something it will be great. Since my hair is totally sticky, you can see, so obviously you cannot leave it open, it won't look nice. So what I do, either I have a hairband like this, separates, and like I will tie my hair. I just roll and I have it open like so. I have this, I broke. I have another one. Let's try this. You can use any of your favorite rubber band or some kind of fancy clip. Now pass through this like this. I hope you can see. It's a small bun and front will be like this. So yeah, you can leave some hair or can have some kind of bun. I prefer bun. And if suppose I have to wear sunglasses and all, so I will take a bun on top. It's an afternoon, I have a shade, so I prefer not to wear hairband because, you know, both to tuck in your head, it's a bit difficult. So I just comb like this and wanted to have a sleek and tight bun. People prefer sometimes pony or some kind of poof. But since it's oily, I don't want to do any poof kind of thing. So, cut the back, just press the back. You can tie with rubber band or just like twist and roll. And just fix this one. Here. So, yeah, like this. And I have my shades on. And keep out of my head. So this is bit free. Since, out of touch, yeah. So like this. So your head is covered, your head is sleek, and your makeup is perfect. So this is the final look. I'm wearing a jumpsuit. With a shrug. And of course it's summer, so we'll be having my shade on. So this is the final look. So guys, thanks for watching this video. If you really like this video, please hit a like button and subscribe to my channel. And do let me know by commenting below if you like this video and if you have experimented, you know, having a chumpy hair and with a full dress up and went out. I would really love to read all of your comments and would possibly try to reply all of your comments. And till then, see you soon. Bye bye.